Hi, my name is Mylon Fevre, and music is in my blood. I got my first big break when Elvis Presley recorded a song I'd written at 17 years old. That moment changed my life forever. I went from having nothing to having my dreams come true. I toured the world and played with some of the biggest names in music and had more money than I knew what to do with. I finally hit rock bottom when I almost died from a drug overdose, and it became painfully obvious something had to change. Everything did change when I gave my life to Jesus at a Second Chapter of Acts concert in 1980. God instantly delivered me from drugs and totally turned my life around. I began to use my gift of music for the Lord and started a Christian band, Mylon and Broken Heart. It eventually grew to be one of the biggest Christian rock bands in the world at the time. We won several Grammys and Dove Awards, but most importantly, we led over 200,000 kids to Christ. Now, years later, I'm still living for Jesus, and my wife, Christi, and I travel the globe proclaiming God's goodness. I've been from rock bottom to the mountaintop, and I'm going all the way to heaven. So come on and join me on the road to freedom.
Freedom. We're so glad you tuned in today. We're in Big Sur today, and we are in this magnificent part of the country where we've been riding around. I've come up through here on motorcycles so many times. We're on beautiful Highway 1 going all the way up the coast. It's just beautiful. We'll show you a lot of it in the next in the shows that we're recording this week. Today is the first day of forever. Yeah. I don't know what's going on in your life, but forever is a long time. And according to the Bible, the decisions we make today, life, as we call it, you know, I'm in my 70s. Life is short compared to eternity.
Yes.
Forever is a long time. And the decisions you make today, and so God knew that you'd be watching today. It's not an accident that
That's
we're
right.
getting to talk to you. Before you were created in your mother's womb, God knew that today that he could use me to talk to you or Christi.
Yes.
And so we're going to share some of God's word with you.
Yeah.
As you know, Jesus said in John 8 and 31 and 32, if you continue in my word, you will be my disciples and you will know the truth. And the truth that you know and understand will make you,
free.
That's why we're on the road to freedom.
Yeah,
so we want to share some holy information with you. Man, your life's going to keep getting better and better and better. We love you. We're praying for you. This is my wife, Christi. Check it out.
Well, you know, we are wanting to encourage you today about eternity. You know, it may not be something that you have thought of often, but there is a heaven, there is a future in God. If you choose Jesus, you have an eternity with love. That's your future. God is love. And so we want to discuss eternity with you and how it applies to your life here and now. And in Romans 1:20 says, for since the creation of the world, his invisible attributes, his eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen. Now, yes. I want to express this, please. That's why we go to these beautiful places and show you all this beautiful scenery.
You have a choice where you're going to film. If you're going to do TV shows, you can go spend $1 million on building a studio. Or you can just go out and find a pretty place that God built.
Yeah,
and I mean, you talk about the greatest show on earth.
This is it, y'all.
God makes the coolest places on the earth. So that's why we're coming to you from Big Sur today.
That's right. And so this verse says, his attributes, his power, his nature have been clearly seen, being understood through what has been made. For you to taste and see that the Lord is good, the beauty of his creation really does testify that we serve a good God, a powerful God, a mighty God, and he is the creator.
Yes.
And he's ready to create some good things in your life. And it says here, it says that His power is seen through what has been made so that they are without excuse.
Nobody has an excuse to say there's no God.
Right.
You see what That's He's created. It. My Lord, only He could have
only
done it.
Only He could do it.
Yeah,
but here's what's so important is in order for you to have an eternity in heaven, we must choose Jesus. That's our part.
That's it.
And it says in Romans 5:8, but God demonstrates His own love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Yeah.
John 3:16 says that for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him would not perish, but would have everlasting life. So Jesus, God's only begotten Son, His precious Son died for you while you were yet, didn't care.
Yes, He did.
He died for you. But He gave His most precious gift so that you could receive Jesus by faith. And when you do, you receive everlasting life. That's eternity in heaven with your Creator. And, you know, Mylon, you said something about heaven being wonderful because it's filled with all the things that love creates.
Yeah.
And I love how you put that.
Well,
I thought
the best
that was
part,
beautiful.
What do you love about your life?
Yeah. The
good part is because somebody, there's love involved.
Yeah.
Somebody loved you enough to do good things. The Bible says all good things come from above. Mm-hmm. Good stuff comes from God.
Yes.
All the bad stuff comes from the devil. You know, we've said this before, but God gets the blame for everything. If there's a tsunami and people die, the insurance company calls that an act of God. But the truth is, it's an act of the devil. The thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. When people are hurt, that's not God. God is the one who loves and sent Jesus. So love is going to, heaven is going to be about love because everybody there is going to be in love with God and with each other.
Right.
And you do not want to go to hell because there's not going to be any love there. All the people going there are going to be the ones who hated and who fought, stayed in strife, wouldn't trust God, wouldn't do anything right, use God's name as half a word. Mm-hmm. You don't want to be with those people for all eternity. Mm-hmm. There is a lake of fire.
Yeah.
It's what it says in the Bible is true. And people do go, everybody doesn't go to heaven, even though they act like it on news or if you're watching the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, you know, whoever died that year, they all say I'm sure they're watching us from above. No, some of those people are not watching because they're not above. And we won't go into that, but the bottom line is heaven and hell is not God's choice, it's mine and yours.
Yes.
And it all comes down to just accepting Jesus.
If just you receive believe, Jesus. Yeah.
John 3:16, she just read it to you.
Yeah.
God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten Son that whosoever believes in Him, Jesus, would not perish but have everlasting life. So that's a choice. You get to choose if you believe. And if you do, praise God, man, it's going to keep getting better every day in your life.
That's right. And, you know, once we've made that choice, I just want to encourage you, there is a fight of faith in this life.
Yep.
And it should not be surprising to us when we face challenges and circumstances in this world because John 16:33, Jesus said, "These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace." We have peace in Him. "In this world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, because I have overcome the world." Another version says, "I have deprived the world of its power to harm you."
Good.
1 John 5:4, this is how you win in that fight of faith. "For whatever's born of God overcomes the world, and this is the victory that has overcome the world and everything in it, even our faith." So that's why in 1 Timothy 6:12, it says, "Fight the good fight of faith," because you win. You always win in Him if you don't quit and you don't give up.
Yes.
Now, this is where I want to take it back to laying hold of eternity, because it says here, "Fight the good fight of faith, take hold of the eternal life to which you were called." So this lets me know, here's the reward. Fighting the good fight of faith, He's saying, don't quit, don't give up, because you have eternal reward.
Yes.
You will enjoy the reward for all eternity, forever. So the fight is worth it. That's it.
And 1 John, when you were reading it, baby, it says, "For whatever is born of God overcomes the world." That's what it means to be born again, to be born of God, to be born of the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
When you get born again, you overcome the world.
That's
you don't
right.
have
it.
To. You can be a Christian and be a complete wimp and quit every time it gets hard and beg God to fix it and not do anything He told you to do.
Right.
Or you can use His Word and do what it says, whether it's easy or hard, whether you feel like it or not, and you can overcome every problem that's in the world.
Right, and so this is so good. When you refuse to quit, yes, you receive reward here and now. Praise God.
Yes, we do.
I mean, there is an abundant life in Christ in the land of the living.
Yes, there is.
David said, what would have become of me had I not expected to see the goodness of God in the land of the living, in here and now? So all the promises of God are for you for here and now, so that you can live free from fear, from sickness and disease, from poverty and lack.
Yes.
Jesus wants you blessed.
Yes,
but what I want to remind you of today is don't forget about your eternal reward. Mm. Don't forget. Understand that when you refuse to quit and lay hold of the promises of God and refuse to waver, refuse to compromise your confession of faith, know that you will receive reward, not just for the here and now, but for all eternity. So that eternal perspective should always be an encouragement to us. When I choose to give, when I choose to sow seed, I'm not just going to reap a harvest here. I'm going to reap eternal harvest.
That's right, baby.
You know, when I choose to forgive, I'm not just going to be rewarded here. For all eternity, God sees your obedience, and you will be rewarded for all eternity.
Our giving does, you know, our giving goes to other ministries, and our tithing goes to other ministries, literally all over the world.
Yes.
One of the places that we minister to financially is a church in Jerusalem. Mm-hmm. You know, we the Bible talks about the gospel going to the Jew first and also to the Gentile or to the Greek. And so, you know, as we sow into these different places, she's talking about eternal reward.
Right.
We won't know until we get to heaven how many people came to know Jesus as a result of us helping support them financially. Now, we could have kept all that in our ministry or in our lives, but then we would have ended up less because we wouldn't be trusting God and we wouldn't be seeking first His kingdom.
That's it.
So there is an eternal reward when you get to heaven and you see all the people who got to go to heaven because you were partnered with some ministry somewhere, maybe our ministry.
Mm-hmm.
When you get to heaven and see, you will see why you get that reward as a soul winner.
Yeah.
A soul winner's crown, the Bible talks about. Oh my goodness, people. When you get to heaven, everybody that's going to heaven doesn't get the same reward. Some people will do, Paul said, some people, their ministry is just hay and stubble and they just get burned up. I mean, when the test comes, some people build their house on the rock and some on the sand, and the time that the flood comes and wipes out everything they built. And I've had that happen in my life.
Yeah.
So, you know, this is an eternal, forever gift from God reward that can start today when you start doing things His way.
Well, today we want to share with you about Team Mylon. And Ephesians 4 explains that God gave gifts to the church: apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. Our responsibility as teachers is to build up the body of Christ.
Yeah.
And we are, all of us together, are the body. And in Ephesians 4, it also says, as each part does its own special work, it helps the other parts to grow.
Yeah.
So that the whole body is healthy and growing and full of love. As you can see, we all are called to do our part. And today we'd like to invite you to be a part of Team Mylon. Our heart is to reach the multitudes. Joel says that there are multitudes, multitudes. It says it twice. This is a great number of people who are in the valley of decision right now.
That's right.
And it says, for the day of the Lord is near. Jesus is coming soon.
We're in the last of the last days.
Yes, we are.
You know. So if you want to join Team Mylon, if you'll do your part, we need your help. We can't do this alone. Nobody can. But we can tell millions of people. With God's help and with your help, we can tell millions of people what God has done for them. I'm a teacher.
That's
In order to do what I'm called to do, I need some people who are literally kings of our God when it
yes.
comes to industry and entrepreneurial mm-hmm. champions for Jesus.
That's right.
Who can help finance the gospel going forth to the nations.
Yes.
If you're that person and you'd like to be a part, check us out at Mylon.org. God bless you, man. Welcome to Team Mylon.
Again, be encouraged today to fight. Keep fighting the good fight of faith. That simply means you stay in faith. And when you do that, you take hold of the eternal life to which you were called.
If you have sickness in your body, you're not fighting that sickness. What you're really fighting is the spirit of fear.
So good, yeah.
You're mm-hmm. fighting. The fight of faith means you're not ever fighting against flesh and blood. God
yeah.
said, we're not doing battle against flesh and blood, but against great powers and principalities. In the unseen world, rulers of darkness, and one of them is called the spirit of fear. And when you pray, God, heal my body or my wife or my child or my mom or whatever, when you pray, you're not doing battle against sickness. You're doing battle against that spirit of fear that's trying to convince you that your prayer won't work.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're going to, that's the fight of faith.
Yes.
The fight of faith
that's
is,
it.
God, I believe you're honest and I believe your word is true. And I believe that by his stripes I was healed and therefore I am healed in Jesus' name. That's the fight of faith, even though the doctor and the symptoms and the blood says no, it's not working for you, and you keep believing.
Mm-hmm.
That's the fight of faith.
Yeah, that's so good. So I want to give you some more scriptures concerning your eternal reward. Philippians 3:14, Paul said, I press on towards the goal to win the heavenly prize
yeah.
of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. There is a heavenly prize. Praise
mm-hmm.
God. 2 Corinthians 4:16 and 17 says, therefore we do not become discouraged. Now see, now he's talking about the fight of faith. This
yes.
is Paul again, and he's saying, I do not become discouraged, though our outward self is wasting away, yet our inner self is being renewed day by day. For our momentary light distress, this passing trouble. Now I want to remind you here, Paul here is talking about, I mean, all of the things he went through that he's calling it light distress.
Mm.
And the reason why he could say that when he was in prison, in shackles, he had been beaten with whips, he had been shipwrecked. The reason why he could call it all light distressed is because he compared it to eternity.
Yeah.
And here's where he answered it. Light distressed is producing for us an eternal weight of glory.
Yes, it is.
Praise God, beyond all measure, surpassing all comparisons, a transcendent splendor, and an endless blessedness. Ooh, those are some beautiful words. Beautiful.
That, yeah.
I mean, when you compare what you're going through to the reward that you're going to receive and enjoy for all eternity, then this is light and this is easy. So it's time to choose. You know, one of the things that what Mylon and I have been in light of keeping an eternal perspective each day. And you know what I mean by that, again, is in light of knowing that what we are fighting for each day, this fight of faith, is for an eternal reward.
Yeah.
Then we ask each other, okay, what's important and what's not important? Because we're going to focus on what's really important today.
Yes,
amen. And so I encourage you in that today to really focus on what's important, and you'll find that in the Word. And in Matthew 7:21-23, Jesus said, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven. Now this scripture, every time I read it, it puts me on my knees. I humble myself. I make sure I have everything right with the Lord, because Jesus said, even if you say, Lord, Lord, not everyone who says that will enter the kingdom of heaven. Here's who enters eternity. He who does the will of my Father
yes.
who is in heaven.
That's good.
He who is a doer of the word. And he said, many will say to me on that day. Now, again, we're talking about eternity. There is a day of judgment. The word says that we will answer for even all of our actions here on the earth, but also every word we speak. Again, whoo, puts me on my knees. And I'm humbling myself, yes. But it says to me, now here's the good part though. The blood of Jesus cleanses you from all unrighteousness. So it is so quick to get it right with God so that you are ready on this day. And he said to me, many will say to me on that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in your name? I mean, these are people who went to church. We have prophesied in your name. We have driven out demons in your name. And we've done many mighty works in your name. So they were doing all these things in the name of Jesus. And then Jesus said, I will say to them openly, I never knew you. Depart from me, you who act wickedly. Now, here was his definition of wickedness, disregarding my commands. The commands of God are his word. They're just the instructions in his word.
Exactly.
And so this is so heavy to me because Jesus said, first of all, I never knew you. You know him by your obedience to his word, through your relationship with his word. And again, he said, if you love me, you will obey me. So the more you fall in love with Jesus, the more you want to obey, the more you're looking for ways to please him, to be a blessing to him. This is not a burden or a heavy thing when I think about obedience to the Lord. I want to please him. He is so good to me. He has been so good to us.
I know that I watched you last week in when you came down from your Bible study and showed me this.
Yes.
And we were talking about a lot of things that day. One of them is I'd read in the newspaper about a lady, a very famous person, I won't mention her name, who just committed suicide. And she had sold a company for $125 million. I mean, this lady could do anything she wanted to. She'd go anywhere she wanted to, buy anything she wanted. She was not elderly. She was in good shape physically. She was in her 40s, 50s, I can't remember exactly. A couple of days later, a guy, a very famous guy, who's also a multi-millionaire, committed suicide. Very successful. You would know his name also. All over the world, they kill themselves. You see all the time people who have everything. They can do anything they want to, and yet they found something to be unhappy about. They choose, they don't know what's important and what's not. They're in good health, they're not in pain, they're not dying, nobody's...
That's so good.
I mean, there's not a war going on, they're not being shot at, they're in a place where they could live at peace, and yet they're fussing and griping and finding something wrong. Man, this is a real simple thing, but so important.
Yes.
What is important? What God says is important.
Yes.
And what you do about it, that's important. Mm-hmm. All the other stuff that people fuss and fight about, not so much. Come on. It doesn't matter about most of the stuff that people are freaking out about.
Yeah, it doesn't. And you know, he goes further and says in Matthew 25, 31 through 40, I'm not going to read this whole passage. So he said to the sheep, come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry. Now here's what's important to Jesus. He explains his obedience to his commands, his word. He said, I was hungry and you gave me food. I was naked and you clothed me. I was sick and you visited me. I was in prison and you came to me. Then the righteous will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you? When did we see you thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and take you in, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and come to you? And the king will answer and say to them, assuredly I say to you, inasmuch as you've done it to the least of these, to the least of my brethren, you've done it unto me. You've done it for me. And so I want to encourage you in this. That is true religion. This message of eternity is so important because Romans 6:23 says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God, hallelujah, is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. And that's what God's best is for you, that you receive eternal life in Christ Jesus today. It's a free gift that you just receive by faith. And I want to remind you, Ecclesiastes 3 says, for God has planted eternity in the hearts and minds of man. It's a divinely implanted sense of purpose, working through the ages, that nothing under the sun. Not a career, not money, not a relationship. There is nothing under the sun, but God alone can satisfy. He has placed eternity in you, and only He can meet that need. Only He can grant that desire. So if you've never given your life to Jesus, to the Lordship of Jesus, or you just want to rededicate your life to the Lord today and make the choice for eternal life with Him, will you pray this after me? Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I ask you to forgive me.
I ask you to forgive me.
For all my sins.
For all my sins.
I repent.
I repent.
And humble myself before you.
And I humble myself, sir.
And I choose you, Jesus.
And I choose you, Jesus.
As my Lord and Savior.
As my Lord and Savior.
And I believe.
And I believe.
That God raised you from the dead.
That God raised you from the dead.
And now I receive.
And now I receive.
Eternal life.
Eternal life.
With you.
With you.
Forever.
Forever.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. We believe if you prayed that prayer, that God Almighty came and changed everything in your spirit.
Yes,
we believe
yes.
You invited Him. We believe He came in. That's what His Word says. And your body's now the temple of the Holy Spirit. If you were already a Christian, mm-hmm. we believe that you just rededicated. You mm-hmm. just settled. You took a responsibility for your sins. He cleansed you from all unrighteousness. You admitted and humbled yourself. God, I know I hadn't done everything right. And He forgave you and made it right.
Yes.
So stay in the Word. Remember, if you mm-hmm. continue in the Word, it'll keep you
on the road to freedom.
I asked them to let me read this testimony. I got so excited. I'm so thankful for this, man. Major Anthony, he's in the Salvation Army. He's a good friend of mine. He invited us to come to a meeting, and he sent me a letter telling me about this. One of the men who came to the altar Saturday night came to rededicate his life to Christ. At the time, he had gotten permission to be off from his job for the weekend so he could attend. His job, he's a bouncer at a strip club. After giving his life to Christ and hearing the word of God spoken by Mylon, he went home and told his wife what happened to him. That day he called his boss and told him why he had to quit his job. Today he and his wife are attending the Salvation Army Church. They're bringing their teenage son with them, and the whole family is looking for ways to serve Jesus.
Praise God.
Glory to God, man. That's what it's all about.
Yes, it is.
New life in Christ. And you can have it too if you don't already. All you have to do is ask Him. We love you guys. Come to Mylon.org. If there's anything we can do for you, Team Mylon, you made
Thank
this
you.
Happen,
yes.
man. You sent us to that Salvation Army meeting.
That's
and
right.
65 men gave their life to Christ that night.
Praise
some
God.
Homeless guys, some people in halfway shelters.
Yes.
It all happened because you believed,
yes.
you prayed, and you gave. God bless you guys. Love you.
And you know, if you want to join us at an event near you, please check out our itinerary at mylon.org. We'd love to meet you in person.